Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
Solar researchers discover more and more links between solar and planetary events. The message learned is study the sun. The sun and Earth are no longer thought to be isolated bodies floating in an inert medium. Recent evidence suggests a direct physical plasma link between these two bodies.
NASA launched five spacecraft called the Themis group of spacecraft into Earth orbit, and Themis detected gigantic, what they called tornadoes of plasma, emanating from the sun with over 1 million amperes in each one of these giant funnels of electric energy. They directly impinge on the atmosphere of Earth, on the ionosphere, and they are huge 40,000-mile-wide funnels that come from the sun and touch Earth's electrical environment. So that's a direct connection from Earth to the sun. The implications of the direct connection that the sun has with Earth are that we are going to directly experience on Earth any changes in the nature of the sun's activity. If there are increased sunspots, then the sun is going to emit a greater number of solar flares and a greater number of coronal mass ejections, and those are going to have impact on communications around Earth, as well as on satellite activity. Increased solar activity can actually degrade the orbits of some satellites because the charged particle flow acts like a brake on them and they start descending into lower orbits.
Effects of solar activities on satellites are well known today. However, the effects of the sun on our planet go beyond merely interfering with our communication channels. The sun may have a direct connection with weather and other natural events here on Earth.
Well, it's been shown. There's a gentleman named Henrik Svensmark who's been doing experiments in Scandinavia with solar activity. And he has discovered that when there is an increased level of solar activity, the sun's magnetic field increases, and that causes the cosmic rays from space to be deflected around the solar system. Now, according to Svensmark's theory, when cosmic rays enter our atmosphere, they produce bubble tracks in the atmosphere, very similar to the old bubble chambers that used to detect particles from cyclotron experiments where they would smash atoms together. The particles that were produced would fly through a high humidity chamber. They would cause a pressure reduction and leave a little track of bubbles in the chamber that could be visualized. So what Svensmark determined is that when there are a lot of cosmic rays penetrating Earth's atmosphere, they leave bubble tracks, which creates clouds. So high solar activity deflect these particles around Earth, around the solar system in general. So with increased solar activity, you have a lower number of clouds because fewer of these charged cosmic rays are entering our atmosphere from space. By the same token, when solar activity is low, the particles are not deflected around the solar system, and they do enter our atmosphere, and they do cause an increase in clouds. So the sun could actually be thought of as a cloud generator indirectly, insofar as that it's reducing cosmic ray activity in our atmosphere and allowing more clouds to form, or increasing its magnetic field and allowing fewer cosmic rays to penetrate the atmosphere. Also, the electrical energy from the sun, because it's passed down these giant solar tornadoes directly into Earth's environment, that electrical activity can influence the underground flow of electric currents called telluric currents. And those telluric currents might actually be responsible for earthquakes, underground earthquakes, because magma can be considered a plasma in solid form since it contains a portion of charged particles within it. It can form double layers inside of the magma flow underground, and those layers can actually short out at times and detonate. And if those detonations are occurring in these giant telluric currents underground in huge magma streams, then the double layer detonation could be considered an earthquake, and the seismic waves could be considered the sonic boom. Earth is connected to the sun, as we've demonstrated through these giant plasma tornadoes that the Thema spacecraft has detected. So the sun is right here. The sun is here with us now, and it's affecting everything that we do.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.